at the Turlington. Black eye, a fuchsia lip, and a black nail. Can't beat it.
Tabitha Turlington, possibly one of the most genuine queens and a very, very dear friend, has never lost perspective of what she is and what she does. She's a man in a frock getting up there having a damn good time. Two people, 200 or 2,000, it is Tabitha Turlington. That's what I love about her. Fucking genuine article. Give her my fucking heart and soul.
About your signature dance style.
Well, I don't really dance. I think that's a theme with most of us, except for Sasha Starr. I'm Laura Gravity.
You have a style, a particular style.
Do I?
Yes, it's a thing with the.
Because I love to show off the nails, which I've taken.
And then the legs do the.
The legs do like a wobble, yeah. Something, do they? And yes. The spin.
And you put your weight on one leg and. Yeah, and then a spin with your pants showing.
And rock it, and they give a bit of a flash. Because I first saw lipstick, so Le Gore was all about the hands. That's the first show. And so I always think the first drag or show you see, you're sort of influenced by them. Well, I was. Demi was my idol, but that was the first show I saw. So Le Gore was always hands and nails. And Dorian was about the spin. And Candy was funny. You know, Candy would do the funny stuff. So I think I sort of have a combination of those girls when I in my performance, which has then evolved into me. But I'm more like step point, step point, step point, 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 spin. That's the Turlington way.
I've loved Tabitha for years. We worked together in many, many shows. She's got the camp. She's very quick on the microphone, and she's a lot of fun in the dressing room. I love her.
I think she brings a good energy into the dressing room and stage. She's always fun, camp, over the top. She loves it.
Thank you. Good evening, welcome. How are you all this evening? First of all, just look outside the door and check out the new security guard, the Serbian. Not the bald one, the other one. Where's the other one? Where's the other one? Tell him to come here. Quickly, he's so sexy. My ovaries are doing the cha-cha. Like I'm vibrating at 100 miles an hour. He's, oh God, he's gorgeous. He's so sexy. I don't speak any Serbian. All I say is, I swallow. That's all I know. Look at him, ladies and gentlemen. Put your hands together for security. Look at him. Oh, they wanted to meet you. I said, let him do his job. And they said, no, we have to meet you. What's your name, darling? Put your hands together, Dale, isn't he gorgeous? How old are you?
25.
25, so he's young, dumb, and full of cum, ladies. You're a straight man?
Sorry.
I smelt that, darling, it's very lovely. Go back to work. Put your hands together for a gorgeous Serbian. Oh, you could blow at me anytime. Call me, baby. How about that, BJ? My God. Oh. I'm going to take my teeth out for him.
I used to be the bitch of the year. I went bitch of the year a couple of times, twice. Dulcie won it about three or four times. But it was more of a mark of, once I started performing, I loved miming being camp, the Barbra Streisand. But when I started comparing, I started talking, and I could see that I could make people laugh or squirm, that's the thrill I got out of it. So I sort of, even though I still mime and perform to numbers, I don't actually get enjoyment out of it, because for me, once I'm talking on the microphone, then I go to miming a song, it doesn't read real. So that's why I preferred just comparing, but you have to do both. Or they went, hey, you, the cheek of them.
Oh, gee, a smile on my face straight away. What can I say about Tab? Long association, known her for more years than I care to mention. Gotten to know her very sort of, in a personal way in the last couple of years. The utmost respect, wonderful person, wonderful personality. She and I had our differences years ago. We used to sort of flare up at each other. But again, it was the 90s, who didn't? And as I've already said, there was always, you know, substances involved, and that used to heighten emotions. And Tab and I sort of flared, and, you know, we were in a few shows together and didn't see eye to eye. But since then, guested on her shows a couple of times, think she's fantastic, you know, she's great. Really love Tab.
Wow, Tab. Watching her from the exchange days to being a guest on her show here, she has provided a vehicle for so many people to come and do spots, which is slowly running out, but she's fantastic. Love her.
For this beautiful new newcomer, sort of new, still young, still gorgeous. She's just come back from the Middle East where she was married. Mahaba, welcome back from Lebanon. Give it up for the one, the only, the beautiful Miss Angel. Better come, make her welcome!
Project Pussy Night, we're friends, so I think I was at the best time we did shows with friends. So I did shows with Vivian and Lucy, friends, I did with Caress and Lucy as friends, Femme Fatale, Sky Brooks, Caress, friends. It's always friends, Sue Ridge, Drag Squad, Lagore, Candy, friends. So it's ultimately about, if you're having fun together, the friends, and you take that friendship and that fun and you put it out on stage and everybody enjoys it. If you enjoy it, they enjoy it. So I've always liked that. But another part of the drag that I've always loved doing is I find some drag performers, when new talent comes out, like Ivy Munro, Regime Detol, they're scared of them because they're so good. So I think they're scared they're going to lose their spot or they're not going to be wanted anymore. So they try and push them away. But I think you need to encourage them because you need new blood to keep the scene going and to keep the drag world going. So I always encourage, encourage, encourage. And that's what I like doing on the Friday Project. When Pussy passed away, I started having friends on. So I had all the young ones, Missy Leminx, Lexi Gaga, all those sort of jacking me off. I had all those young girls, and because I love watching them. So the reason I love doing the show is because I love watching a drag show just as much as I love being in one.
Tabitha Cam. She's so fucking funny, and from day one she's always been a doll to me, like never been rude. I'm sure like she can be rude, but never been rude to me, and fucking hilarious.
Tabitha Turlington used to hate me. She used to make my life hell. At the time, I always thought it was because I was blonde and she was blonde too. But in hindsight, I think it's just because she hated me. But in recent years, she's softened and now we've actually become quite sisterly. I love her and, you know, we have a lot of laughs together. She's one of the ones that clogs up my inbox, actually. So now you know who does it. But, yeah, I love Tab now and I think she's... I don't know what the hell happened to her in the last couple of years, but she turned a 180 and she's just, yeah, she's really nice now. It's weird.
No Vagina, I think she is, she's got her head screwed on, she's no nonsense, she knows to have fun, she's a good friend, she's a loyal friend, and I think what I liked about her, I think that she thought she wasn't being treated fairly at a venue, so she said, you know what, fuck you, I've worked with you for so long, and she left and she started her own show, and so I applaud her for that. And also, she's a young drag queen that put herself through school. A lot of them just fall into the drugs and drug category, but she's done something with herself, and drags help pay for that, so kudos to Nova. I've done drag for 24 years next year, and I've worked every single week of those 24 years, except I took 1 year off. And I didn't miss drag at all. At all. I was quite happy never to do it again. Pussy really wanted to do the Friday Night Project. It was called Bitch then, started by Lawrence and Claude. And I didn't think they would let her have done it if I didn't do it. So I said, yes, I'll do it. And I came back and then I really enjoyed it. And then Pussy died and I was gonna stop doing it then, but I thought I didn't want the end of my drag career to be sort of like tainted because she died. So I've kept going. And there's been a few times where I thought I should stop. You know that song, Have I Stayed Too Long at the Fair? For me, not for others, for me. Because I always thought when I started doing drag, I wanted to finish around 40, and I'm 43 now. So I'm sort of around that timing, because I didn't want the character Tabitha to be old. Like, she was a young slut. I don't want her to be like an old hag. I'm probably getting there, but not yet. I'm still ripe. I haven't gone off yet. So I'm getting out while I'm still ripe, as a friend said to me today.
Tabitha Turlington, Kukla.
Kukla, yeah.
Kukla, yeah. Thanks very much.
Kukla Moo.
Yeah. Fabulous, Tammy. Thanks very much for putting me on. I miss you. Good luck for your future, whatever you're doing, club.
Tabitha Turlington. I've been working with Tabitha Turlington right from the beginning. She was actually one of the judges when I did my talent quest years ago when I first started and won. I've known her since then. We were in Three Faces shows together. Everyone will remember those. Exchange shows together. Everyone will remember those. Greyhound show together. Nobody will remember that one. But she has been fantastic. She's given a platform. She's, there's so many ghosts in this place, I swear. Can't say names though. She's given a platform for all the up-and-coming girls, us older girls that don't get gigs anymore. She's been fabulous. She's wonderful. She's one of the best hostesses. Kerry Lagore, Tabitha Turlington, two of the best hostesses on the microphone you'll ever get. She's quick, she's fast, psychotic, but we love her for it. She's beautiful. She would give you the shirt off her back. Wouldn't take it though. Fucking stinks. No, she's a beautiful girl. It's so sad that she's going away. She says she's hanging up all week. She won't hang up all week. It's in her blood. She'll be there to the bitter end. She's got a beautiful boyfriend now, but she wants to spend time with him. Lovely. That's nice. Yes, that's nice.
Loved Tabby. Very good on the mic. Good with the Polari. With the old cigarette in the fingers, that old show trick. I love Tabby. Tabby's great value.
You know she just hung up the wig.
We all go through stages. Look, see, I was going to today, I didn't even shave my chest. See, I was just, you know, on the border of like, I'm going to just give up the razor right here and now, but I did the face. That's about all you get.
Can I interject?
Yes.
We've all given up at one stage or another. You have. We all get to that point where it's just too much and you think, I've got to get the fuck out of here. And you do it, but we always come back.
We always
come back. Because the lure of the grease paint is very strong.
It is. All that pretty. Mm. On just, you know, the excuse to buy more costumes. Hence why I'm loving my lovely engagement here at DT's once a month. I can still dip my toe in the sequin waters, so to speak.
Exactly, yeah.
Yes.
Now, it's been a little bit down the track. It's like, what, 3 years or something since Pussy died?
Mm.
That night that you performed the tribute, how did you do that? I was filming you and I was howling my eyes out.
All right, so, okay. To Pussy. Mm. The week she died, Pussy's death for me, Vivian died, and it was one... When you sometimes you lose friends, just a shock. But Vivian and I had always planned when she was older, we were going to do this, we're going to do that, we're going to do this, we're going to do that. We were all happy doing our own thing. And then Pussy died, and that one, that cut my legs off. That gutted me. I was wrecked forever for that. Not forever, for a long time. But the week of the tribute show to Pussy, I just knew I had to do it for her. And she always wanted to do Xanadu. That's why I do Xanadu so much now. And I wanted to do this version, because I wanted to do the version that goes... The love, the dream, but she doesn't like the version. She just wanted to do the love, the echoes of long. So we had this fight because we both wanted to love the song, wanted to do it, but she wanted her way and I wanted her way. And then when she died, I thought, you could have given in. So now I do that for her. And it always says, you're here with me, which for me means that she's here with me. So that's why I do that a lot. It's gonna do.
It's lovely.
Yeah.
Thank you.
knits, but I think I just need to wash my hair. And when my nails are long, I look scrappy in my scalp. Isn't that retarded? But that's what I love doing. I think it's years of wearing wigs.